Yes, my name is Daniel Dunn. That is D-A-N-I-E-L-D-U-N-N. I will request permission. I know we have 3 minutes, but the speaker behind me is Harrison Isaacs, and he's got 3 minutes also. Can we combine it and make 6 minutes?
So, are you going to do 6 minutes or?
Yeah. No, I'll do, yes. But if I don't finish in 6 minutes, then we would finish the rest of it afterwards.
Three for you and three for him?
Yes.
That's fine. Yeah, that's
okay.
Fine.
All right.
Yes, Jack. And then keep in mind, if you don't finish, we'll open it back up.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you for hearing us tonight. I'm here on behalf of GBA Associates, LLC, and Mr. Gregory K. Isaacs. Unfortunately, there has been little to no effort on part of Sable Trail to communicate with us. They have continued to not respond to our requests for information and requests for meetings. We have made these requests directly with Sable Trail, with filings with FERC. Sable Trail continues to operate under the darkness of misinformation. We have documented these efforts and Sable Trail's lack of response. These will be available in coming litigation. On page 3-134 of the draft EIS FERC directed to Sable Trail to communicate and work out these routing issues, which they have not done. No updated alignment sheets have been provided. On page 4-30, the map figure 4.3, 2-2 is the first time we've seen these routes, as Sable Trail has not supplied this information. These options should be researched with transparency and in good faith discussion, which has not happened. It appears that variation that detours south of the city limits would be the best other than the co-located route. They appear to only be concerned about themselves and what they can conquer. Makes me think of a bull in the China closet. There is no way for a for-profit corporation, there's no reason for them to conduct business like this. On page 3-134 of the draft EIS, Sable Trail states Moultrie Community Planning Department were not aware of our development. While the planning department may not know of the discussion, members of the development authority and real estate agents in the community are aware. And please understand the process of site selection for a retail development does not require the planning department at this stage of the negotiations. We have invested thousands of dollars to get to this point with the development. The very reason we purchased the property was because of the tract being the best retail development opportunity on the south side of Moultrie City limits. We also supplied Sable Trail appraiser the maps, renderings, and details of the development. We then filed a complaint, 20150608-5102, on the FERC docket to correct this misinformation. The statement that no one knows of this development is false and untrue. We have repeatedly requested FERC and Sable Trail to return to the FERC preferred co-locate route with the SONET pipeline. As SONET has stated, the route appears to cross and deviate from where Sable Trail is having difficulty with landowners and co-located route. We have asked Sable Trail repeatedly where any obstruction is located that would require such an expensive greenfield reroute, of which Sable Trail has not come forth in good faith to discuss the specific location of such an obstruction. In the filings, Sable Trail has indicated residential and commercial development. There is no commercial development impacted, and the only residential obstruction to be one small vacant house on Bale Trace Court Southeast. Let me repeat that. There is no commercial development impacted, and the only residential obstruction appears to be the one vacant house on Bell Trace Court Southeast. We have requested Sable Trail to use other methods of their own choice to get through this area, such as necking down, dragging in the pipe for installation. We understand that boring method could be also used, as well as horizontal and directional drilling. These are normal requirements for pipeline construction. Also, the small foreclosed house that is mentioned could be purchased for some $60,000 or less, then removed for pipeline installation. This is the best route, co-located with Sunman. Let me repeat that. This is the best route, co-located with Sunman.
Mr. Dunn, I'll interrupt you for just one second. Is Mr. Isaac going to continue his comments, or? I just want to be fair to everybody.
I'm good. Give me my time.
No. Okay, I just. I just want to make sure I'm fair to everybody and giving them 3 minutes. If you're going to give him his time, I'll let you finish and then have that total be 6.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So I need to speak now. Is that where you're
Well, the three of you all signed up to speak, right?
Right.
And you're going to not speak and give your.
I'll give.
That's fine.
Okay. So, Sable Trail has been purchasing right of way on Greenfield Route, and they are now biased and incapable of making the correct decision to return to the Sunap co-located. As the Commission has long recognized, co-location can have significant benefits by reducing impacts to the environment and surrounding communities, as well as safety of pipelines and its operation. As we have reached an impasse with Sable Trail on routing issues, we had requested the use of FERC's advanced dispute resolution process to allow for some honest communication. Sable Trail has refused to come to the table in good faith and has refused to participate in the ADR process. Sable Trail forced their way on our property with a statute we feel was not intended for building a huge interstate pipeline. It is for local utilities and energy companies doing business in their communities to expand and service their local communities here in Georgia. Sable Trail does not have any active customers we know of in Georgia, and they are not designated as an operating utility at this point. It's confusing how a state statute is used to gain access to private property here in Georgia when Georgia citizens receive no benefit. They should be using federal statutes in federal court if they're going to contend Georgia landowners. We have filed an accepted motion to intervene 20150203-5076 with FERC and have asked and requested FERC's assistance. We will be looking forward to your help in the coming future. With the existence of these issues of misinformation, corporate misbehavior, and lack of good faith negotiation, we request the following. In the event variation 3 is adopted or any route through the property of GBA Associates and Mr. Isaac, then FERC would preempt and not allow the rights of eminent domain and condemnation on these properties alone. Let me repeat that. In the event of variation 3 is adopted or any route through the property of GBA Associates and Mr. Isaac's, then FERC would preempt and not allow the rights of eminent domain and condemnation on these properties alone. Thank you for the opportunity to speak with you tonight.
Thank you, Mr. Dunn. Mr. I-